Welcome back. We're looking at modern authentication for native client applications. In this case, Outlook is trying to get a token to talk to Exchange Online. In the previous section, in part one, we looked at the interactive portion of the sign-in where Outlook obtained an authorization code. Let's look at what happens now as Outlook performs the non-interactive part of the flow to finally get a token and then to do things over time. So now that Outlook has the code, it can send that code to this other endpoint on Azure Active Directory, which is the token endpoint. And it will pass along its client ID to indicate this is, hi, I'm Outlook, the code that it received, and the fact that, yes, it wants a token for Exchange Online. The code is actually a form of a short-lived security token. It's only good with use with Azure Active Directory. And Azure Active Directory will validate all of this information and then send back to Outlook an access token and a refresh token. It's the access token that Outlook is finally going to use when it makes calls to Exchange Online. And it's going to send that access token on every request it makes to the REST endpoint of Exchange Online, and it's going to send it in what's called the authorization header of each request. Exchange Online knows to lift that token out of the authorization header, and by virtue of the fact that it trusts Azure AD and knows Azure AD's signing key, it can validate the signature on the access token, extract the claims, know that this is our hero Alice, who's about to check her email, and then do work for Alice, whatever the particular REST call was. Access tokens are short-lived tokens. They typically only last for about an hour, and then they expire. If Outlook realizes, oh, this token is expired, or if Exchange tells Outlook, the token you just sent me is expired, then Outlook needs to get a new access token. And that's where this thing called the refresh token comes in. We're not going to have to do the interactive authentication again. All Outlook has to do is take that refresh token and send it to the token endpoint of Azure AD again, along with the parameters, hi, I'm Outlook's client ID. Here's a refresh token that I received previously, and again, I want a new access token for Exchange Online. At this moment, Azure Active Directory is going to do all of the usual authentication checks that it does when it signs you in. It's going to make sure that your user account is still valid and still exists. It's going to do all of its adaptive authentication checks, like conditional access checks, identity protection checks. Maybe the user needs to do a multi-factor authentication now, because previously when they signed in, they were on a particular network which was trusted, but now they're on a network which isn't trusted. If Azure Active Directory decides that the user needs to do a new interactive authentication, then it will send back an error and say the refresh token is expired. But if everything else checks out and the refresh token is still good, then Azure Active Directory will simply respond back with a new access token and usually a new refresh token that Outlook is now going to cache and replace the previously cached version. That happens anytime Azure Active Directory needs to update what's in the refresh token that it's given to Outlook. And then Outlook can take the new access token and use it to call Exchange again. This protocol sequence can go on pretty much indefinitely until Azure Active Directory decides for one reason or another that the refresh token is expired. But since it can go on for a long time, that's what keeps you signed in on your mobile device or on your PC in Outlook and not having to enter your credentials over and over again. It's this non-interactive part of the flow. What we've looked at here and the way that we've done this with Outlook and Exchange for modern authentication is an OAuth 2.0 protocol flow that's called the authorization grant flow, authorization code grant. And the kind of client of Outlook is actually called a public client. And it's called a public client because Outlook doesn't have a secret that it's using to prove that it is Outlook to Azure Active Directory. It can't do that because the Outlook binary goes everywhere onto your phone and onto your PC, and you could decompile it and extract any secrets that might be in there. So there can't be any secrets in there And that's why in the protocol standard, we call this a public client, as opposed to a web server, which might do a similar flow that can have secrets. That's called a confidential client. And that's the basics of how modern authentication works with native client applications.